Hello everyone, I'm Swati and in this video I will be showing you guys how you can solve question 1 and 2 using master method. So I'll be just focusing on the formulas for a dividing function that are given under master method. But if you were looking for the theoretical concept of the formula of master method, then you can check out my other videos on my YouTube channel. So let's get started. Dividing function has a standard format, which is tn is equal to a tn by b plus fn. So while solving the questions of master method, you just have to find a, b and fn and figure out which case your question belongs to and put out the values and you will get the complexity. So the approach is quite simple. Let's see how to apply it. The first question is tn is equal to 16t n by 4 plus n cube. So for solving this question, you just have to compare it with the standard formula. As you can see, this is a dividing function as it is similar to this tn is equal to a tn by b plus fn. So your first step is to find what is the value of a. So as you can see, by comparing these two equations, a is 16 and b is 4, right? And your fn is n cube. Now, next thing that you have to do is you have to see what is the value of k and p. Now, here fn is given as nk log of pn. So you have to compare these two terms and find out what is the value of k and p. So it's easy to say that k is equal to 3. And considering since here is no log coefficient, so the coefficient of n cube is 1. And by that you can say p is equal to 0 because log of 0n is 1, right? So now we have a, b, k and p. The next thing that you have to do is you have to find out log a with base b, right? So it will be log 4 16, which is 2. So now you have to compare log of b of log a base b and k. So k is 3, log a base b is 2, and therefore k is greater. So now it's very clear that which case it belongs to. There are three cases, case 1, case 2, case 3, and as you can see 2 is less than 3, so our question belongs to case 3. And since p is equal to 0, it belongs to case 3 part 1, which is p is greater than 0. So we just have to put our value in this equation. So it will be tn theta of n. What is k? K is 3. And what is p? P is 0. So log 0 of n is equal to 1. So you don't need to write this. So this is our complexity. This is our final answer. So it was pretty simple, right? So this is a solution. Now, try to solve this question and see how much you have got the concept. Pause this video for a while and then I'll show you how to solve this question. So hope you have paused the video. This is the solution. This is the answer. N square log square n. So let's see how to solve this. Again, the same thing, you have to find out a, b and k and p, right? Again, comparing it with the standard formula, you can easily say that a is equal to 4, b is equal to 2, and comparing this with n k log pn, right, which is this formula. So here you can say k is equal to 2 and p is equal to 1. So having found this, now you have to search the value of log a base b, which is log 4, 2, and this is 2, and k is 2. Log a base b and k are equal since both the values are 2. So which case it belongs to? It belongs to case 2. And since p is 1 and it is greater than minus 1, so our solution will be this. So putting the value in this, tn is equal to theta of n. What is k? K is 2. What is p? P is 1. So what will be our final answer? It will be n square log square n. So this is our final answer. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you understood the concept. If there is any doubts, feel free to write in the comment section. If you have any feedback or suggestions, please do write them down in the comment section. I would love to hear them. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.